In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, today we celebrate the feast of Saint Matthias. He was chosen by lot and added to the 11 apostles in the place of Judas Iscariot. So, thus, he chosen by God, and yet he was sent forward to bear fruit by proclaiming the good news. And today, Mass, we offer pray for the repose of the soul of Violette Narciso, Felicia Gassim, Raul Rodriguez Cavantes, Jose Patrice, wife of Porto, Manuel and Maria Diana, Luis de Sousa, and Manuel and Anna Victoria, Joao Maria and Nivia Dennis. Now let's acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Father, glory to God, glory to God.
Let us pray. O God, who assigned St. Matthias a place in the College of Apostles, grant us, through his intercession, that, rejoicing at how your love has been allotted to us, we may merit to be numbered among the elect. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Lectura del libro de los Hechos de los Apóstoles. En aquellos días, Pedro se puso de pie en medio de los hermanos y dijo: Hermanos, tenía que cumplirse aquel pasaje de la Escritura en que el Espíritu Santo, por boca de David, hizo una predicación tocante a Judas, quien fue el que guió a los que apresaron a Jesús. Él era de nuestro grupo y había sido llamado a desempeñar con nosotros este ministerio. Ahora bien, en el libro de los Salmos está escrito que su morada quede desierta y que no haya quien habite en ella, que su cargo lo ocupe otro. Hace falta, por lo tanto, que uno se asocie a nosotros como testigo de la resurrección de Jesús, uno que sea de los que nos han acompañado mientras convivió con nosotros el Señor Jesús, desde que Juan bautizaba hasta el día de la ascensión. Propusieron entonces a dos, a José Barsabá, por sobrenombre el Justo, y a Matías, y se pusieron a orar de este modo: Tú, Señor, que conoces los corazones de todos, muestra a cuál de estos dos has elegido para desempeñar este ministerio y apostolado, del que Judas desertó para irse a su propio lugar. Echaron suertes, le tocó a Matías y lo asociaron a los 11 apóstoles. Palabra de Dios.
Te alabamos, Señor.
Thank you. Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment: love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but it was I who chose you and appointed you to go out and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask of the Father in my name, I may give you. This I command you: love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today we celebrate the Feast of St. Matthias. So you may ask the questions that, where did St. Matthias come from? So we had not heard his name mentioned in the Gospel, the four Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, doesn't mention his name. But yet, as the first reading said, that he was chosen by lot. So he was not chosen by the democratic appointed, not chosen by the apostles that gathered together to appoint him, but the apostles recommend him and another one. So two was recommended, but then let the Lord chose Matthias. So yet he definitely that witnessed Jesus from the baptism until his ascension. And now the Lord chose him. The Lord has chosen him in order to send him go forward to bear fruit. And yet today, the college of the bishops that we call that the successor of the apostles. And the head of the college of bishops is the Pope. So yet, the bishops serve the church and the successor of the apostles, and yes, we priests, and you are all of us, that God's children governed by the Pope and the local bishops. So yet, and in the gospel today, Jesus again telling his disciple that, remain in my love, because the Father loved me. So in turn, I love you. Because of the Father loved me, so I love you. And we know that the Father loved Jesus very much. And yet, in turn, Jesus loved us the same thing. He loved us so much. And the love of a Father to Jesus is the unconditional love. And yet, Jesus loved us in the same way. Unconditional love and everlasting love. And that love, he called us to do the same with our brothers and sisters. And in the midst of this pandemic, you may ask, does really God love me? Why do I experience these scary things? And I don't know what the future is. Yet, God knows the whole picture. God knows the whole picture. And we only see what right in front of us. But God knows the whole picture, the big picture. So therefore, God have his plan, and I don't know what is that. But I read this. Maybe the answer for the question that does really God loves us? So it said that sometimes God break our spirit to save our soul. Sometimes he break our heart to make us whole. Sometimes he send us failure so we can be humble. Sometimes God send us illness so we can take care of ourselves better. Sometimes he takes everything away from us so we can learn the value of everything that we have. So, do you think that God loves you? And should we do and carry out the command that Jesus called us to do? That is, to love one another as he has loved us.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and workable hands, it become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and workable hands, it become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice and turn us
for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, the offerings of your church, reverently presented for the feast of St. Matthias, and through them strengthen us by the power of your grace, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you, Eternal Shepherd, do not desert your flock, but to the blessed apostles, watch over it and protect it always, so that it may be governed by those you have appointed shepherds to lead it in the name of your Son. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending out your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaken of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Myron Cara, our bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy, especially Violet Narciso, Felicia Galsin, Raul Rodriguez Cervantes, Jose Patris and wife Porto, Manuel and Maria Diana, Luis de Sousa, Manuel and Ana Vitoria, Joao Maria and Nivia Tennis. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Bernard, Saint Matthias, Saint Magdalene of Canossa, and Saint Josephine Bakita, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to become heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from the distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lord.
Lord, I am
not worthy that you should enter my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Never cease, O Lord, we pray, to fill your family with divine gifts and to the blessed Matthias' intercession for us, graciously admit us to the share in the Lord of the saints in light, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
San Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle.
We are saved from
the snare of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirit who prowl about the world seeking their own souls. Amen. Most sacred heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Immaculate heart of Mary,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Bernard,
pray for us.
Right after the Mass, we have adoration, so please join us. And now bow your heads for God's blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May God, who has granted you to stand firm on apostolic foundation, graciously bless you to the glorious merits of the Holy Apostle Saint Matthias. Amen. And may he who endowed you with the teaching and example of the apostles make you under their protection witnesses to the truth before all.
Amen.
So that through the intercession of the apostles, you may inherit the eternal homeland, for by their teaching you possess firmness of faith. Amen. And may the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Have a blessed day.